Your fifth fight of the night, amateur, mixed martial arts, scheduled for three 3-minute rounds. In the red corner, weighing in tonight at 172 pounds, fighting out of Legacy from Franklin, North Carolina. With an undefeated record, 1 win, no losses, red corner, Dustin Chovanic. His opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, weighing in tonight at 170 pounds, fighting out of Top of the Line Fitness from Atlanta, Georgia. Also with an undefeated record of 1 win, no losses, blue corner, Darrell, Parodi. Two undefeated fighters, someone loses tonight. Fight five, your referee, Mr. Blake Grice. And once again, welcome to round one of the fifth fight from Hooters and Jack Daniels.
Hi, I'm Carrie Christmas.
I'm Kevin Gutemeyer.
We're here watching the Wild Bills fight night from Wild Bills in Duluth, Georgia. We're on fight number five right now, Darrell Brody and Dustin Chovanic. This looks to be a really good fight.
Yeah, both guys.
All right, Wild Bills, two undefeated fighters. Both of them want it. Let's hear you scream. This is going to be a good one.
Yeah, both these guys are, oh my God,
wow.
Big kick.
Coming out of the gate with a sidekick like that.
Just like we've seen with every other fight tonight, action right off the bat.
Yeah, they're not wasting any time tonight.
No.
Both undefeated, so.
They're making the ref earn his paycheck tonight. Yeah, neither one wants to lose. They're both undefeated. Big takedowns. He goes immediately to mount. He really should pass the side to alleviate that choke.
Looks like he's trying to sink that choke in.
Yeah, Dustin's probably going to use this to take his back, though, as soon as he can break that hold on his leg.
Darrell wanted me to give a shout-out, too. He's an active-duty Marine, and he said this fight is going out to Unit HMLA 773, who just deployed.
Oh, that's tight. That's a tight neck crank.
Tight.
It's not a choke, but it's a neck crank. It could become a blood choke, though, but that's a lot of pressure on the neck. He keeps going for full mount. He needs to just pass and get the side mount, though. Rough stopping him. I didn't see what it was, though.
Yeah, I didn't see what it was either. This is a very fast-paced fight.
Yeah, the ref's really got to be on point in this match. Blake's the best, though. He sees things no one else can see. It might have been an accidental headbutt. Yeah, I think it was an accidental headbutt. It's in a fast-paced fight like this, it's an unfortunate occurrence, but sometimes it does happen.
Looks like that's what he's saying. One more headbutt?
I think he took a point away.
Oh, took a point away. Blake Grice reffing the match tonight.
Yeah, Blake's got the best eye in the business.
And he's not afraid to jump in there and move him, too.
No, absolutely not. He's a big guy. He's a former fighter himself. It gives him a different perspective. Oh. That came close to landing.
Yeah.
Oh, big knees. Big knees, though. Wow.
Ooh. He's not stopping with those knees.
No. To the thighs, to the midsection. He's trying to bring him up.
I
Oh, return to knee. They're trading blows. These are hard. These are going to make it tough in the second round. Goes for the takedown. That was stuff, though. He's going to try to soften him with that choke a little, slow blood choke.
Now, how well does that work from the standing position?
It's not going to tap the guy out likely, but it can soften him up a little bit, just enough to throw him down and spin behind him.
All right.
Or land a big knee to the midsection. You guys trying to come on the table with us. Okay, he wants to stand back up. He wants to land some more of his kicks. He likes to kick, but he feels comfortable with that. They're starting to fatigue a little. Yeah, they're really making Blake earn his money tonight.
What a first round, man.
Absolutely. Let's see who comes out winded in the second round. That was a lot of action by both men. It's going to be very difficult to sustain that again, but they may be able to do it.
Well, neither one of them have a loss. I think neither one of them are going for a loss tonight either.
No, they both want to win. They're trying to figure out who they are, what they're capable of in their minds. You know, everybody wants to know if they're that next big thing. And these fights, you know, help answer that question.
Now, Dustin said backstage that his nickname is 4x4. I think he said he hits like a 4x4.
Yeah, I think so.
He definitely looks to be the striker.
That first kick definitely hit like a 4x4, man.
Yeah.
I mean, that was a devastating kick. I mean, that can end fights sometimes. That's a lot of impact. Yeah, he's pretty flexible. He's fast with his kicks. A lot of people tighten up in the second round. Their leg muscles tighten up. He's pretty loose. Oh, big hooks.
Oh, it looks like he was going for the takedown there with his body.
Oh, big body lock. Big body lock. Now let's see if he'll pass the side mount or if he'll keep trying the full mount like he's been doing. Every time he gets full mount, he loses it though. Oh, big, big hook. They're starting to get a little winded.
Yeah, it looks like they both are.
Yeah. See, now that... Yeah, he could take his back again. Once he gets deep with the body lock, that's when you capitalize. Oh. That was too close. That hit the head. In the amateurs, they're not allowed to hit the head.
Doesn't like that very much.
See, that was kind of iffy, though. I mean, it kind of scraped up the body, and I don't think it was intentional. It kind of scraped up the chest and did look like it made contact. It's hard to tell on such a high-paced fight. It's just really hard to...
Yeah.
Oh, stiff jab.
He's not happy about being kneed in the face.
Oh, big knee, big knee.
Man.
Oh, these are brutal. These guys are trading. He's blocking well, though. He's defending very well, though. He used his glove to deflect most of those.
Still.
He knows he can't be kneed in the face, so he's protecting the midsection. These are brutal. These are going to take a toll.
Yeah, his body's already turning red.
Yeah, they can change the fight. That can change the whole course of the fight right there. He's got a lot of discoloration on him. Yeah, he needs to separate. Trying to keep the bounce in his step. They're going to go ahead and take a little bit of a breather, I think. Yeah, he wants to slow it down, take a bit of a breather. Darrell shoots in. See, now he's almost inside mount. He needs to settle down, catch his breath, put some weight on the opponent, soften him up with little strikes. He wants a submission, though. He's going to try to go for it. He might get it. With 10 seconds left, I doubt he's going to get this.
Yeah, he's going for it, though.
He can go ahead and put a little pressure on the joint then.
Guys, guy on the bottom, excellent defense. He's holding his hands together. Yeah, it's very hard to get that.
He's got him locked tight. Usually what the pros will do is they'll elbow the face at that point, but the amateurs, they can't elbow. I thought I heard the 10-second bell. Obviously, I didn't. He needs to score. There it is. That's the 10-second bell. I can see the future. Now, he may have this. This looks tight.
I don't think he's got enough time, though.
Wow. Oh. Wow, he just ran out of time. Wow.
That was close. All that work.
Yeah, Darrell's real close to finishing that. Now, this is going to be tough. They're going in the third round. Both guys are putting out a lot of energy. High pace, high action fight.
Definitely. Great fight so far. Probably my favorite fight of the night so far.
Yeah, really every fight's been a great fight so far. It seems tough to do, but they seem to top themselves every time. I'm interested to see if those body shots add up. I know Dustin took a lot of body shots, a lot of knees. He deflected a lot of them with his gloves and his arm, but he did eat a lot as well.
Yeah, and you were saying those add up, especially as the rounds go on. And we're entering the third round, so I'm sure he's pretty sore.
Yeah, right now he's running on hard. He doesn't want to lose his fight. Both these guys showing a lot of heart. They're very tired right now. Tough fight. Neither one wants to lose.
Yeah, with two rounds like that, it'd be impossible not to be this tired right now.
Yeah, they still look composed. Even though they're tired, they're still showing some composure. So that's good. That's good for amateurs at this level to show that kind of composure. Wow. Big hooks. Dustin's landing some big shots. He's timing them well. They're pacing themselves a little bit now, but they need to.
Dustin again with...
just barely misses a big spinning back kick. You can end a fight with that.
Yeah. Ooh.
Wow.
Again with the knees.
Dustin's got to stay out of these clinches. He has to. He needs to keep the distance where he can use his kicks.
Definitely.
He's getting the worst of those clinches. Now those spinning back kicks, had he landed that, those are fight stoppers. Those will end the fight.
The ref just called him for holding onto his shorts.
Well, I think it was a low blow, actually.
It
looked like a knee to the groin.
He was pinning him back by holding onto his shorts. That was just not cool.
Dustin threw an uppercut. Actually, Blake deflected it right at the right time. So again, Blake, you know, with the best eye in the business.
Crowd's definitely not liking that.
Yeah, I don't believe it's intentional. It's tough when you're in a high action fight, high pace. It's things happen. I don't believe it's intentional. It's really hard. You aim for the midsection, your legs start to tighten up. Sometimes it doesn't get all the way up there.
Back to it. This is the third round, so they've got to end the fight now. They don't want it to go to decision.
No, they sure don't. That's going to be a tough fight to judge, and I know Blake awarded some points. It's going to be – he caught him with that kick. It didn't look like it stunned him too bad, but he did catch him. Darrell's coming in a little slow with his punches, but as soon as he gets in that clinch, though – oh, he ate a big one there. As soon as he gets in that clinch, he comes alive, though, with knees. Body lock straight to the mount. Body lock to the mount. Let's see if he can maintain this mount. Against a winded opponent, he has a pretty good chance of maintaining it. No strikes to the head. He was doing shoulder strikes to the head. That's not allowed in amateurs, even the shoulder.
None at all. That's
These are new rules. This is the first fight with the new amateur rules, so it's going to take a little adjustment by the fighters. They've got the shin pads. Oh, nice armbar.
He's sticking with it.
This is going to be tough to defend.
You can't tell, but it looks like he is defending it. He's trying to.
He needs to step over the body and spin out. He can't stay there. Eventually, Darrell's going to break that grip and get the armbar. He's got to run around the body and spin out.
Again, though, does he have enough time to finish this?
With 10 seconds, probably not. Right now, Dustin's going to give it everything he has for 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, he got it.
Oh,
my God. I guess it went to decision. It looked like he dislocated, but I think he twisted it. I think he twisted it to release the pressure at the last moment. Brutal looking armbar, though. Brutal looking, but I think he's okay. I would not want to judge that fight.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, I think that's going to come down to the however Blake awarded points. That's going to be it's going to be a tough fight.
Hey, Bo.
They kept the level of action up the whole fight. They paced it a little bit in the third round, picked their spots to come hard, but they still came hard. I tell you what, a lot of fighters don't realize when it goes to the judges, you have to win that judge. You have to make an impression, and right now that's what Darrell's doing. He's walking around with his arms raised, making the crowd cheer, pointing to people. That plays a big factor in the judge's mind. It's very difficult to judge MMA in close fights. Darrell's doing the right thing right now. Dustin's corner should be telling him to do the same thing, and they're not. This, whether you agree with it or not, that may determine the fight right there.
Really? He's holding up his Marine Corps flag.
Absolutely. Getting a lot of applause from the crowd.
Yeah, definitely think everyone supports the Marines. I myself am a big fan. My dad is a Marine, so.
Absolutely.
Again, he said he wanted his fight to go out to unit HMLA 773. His unit, he is stationed here in Georgia. I guess they just deployed Tuesday.
Yeah, they'll really appreciate that. They'll appreciate him coming in with a flag, bringing some recognition to those guys, what they're doing for us.
Looks like the judges are having a bit of a hard time.
Yeah, I would too. I mean, I'll be honest with you. That's one of those things you'd have to watch, rewatch, and watch again, and you still don't know if you came up with the right decision. One thing you don't see a lot of is draws, and honestly, I see a lot of fights that probably should be a draw. Way too close to tell. No fighter wants a draw on his record, but sometimes there's just no better decision.
Yeah, we're sitting right here eye level with the judges, and that was just a hard fight to follow.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Body language means a lot too. Darrell looks like a winner right now. Dustin doesn't. That's important. They need to teach the fighters
that. I think you enjoyed that one. Let's hear it for both our fighters. That was a good one. Finally, we had a decision. Both these guys went at it 100%. Again, this was our fifth fight of the night, an amateur fight, mixed martial arts, scheduled for three-minute rounds. It went the distance. Judge A saw it 27-29. Judge B, 28-28. Judge C, 27-29. And your winner, by a majority decision, blue corner, Darrell Parodi. Darrell Parodi is your winner.
Good show of sportsmanship by Dustin.
Let's hear it for Dustin Chovanic in the red corner. Good bout.